The National Education Technology Plan places a large emphasis on a variety of things when it comes to infrastructure. It's not just having high-speed broadband internet access. It's having high-speed access for the entire community.
So while they have this technology at school, once they leave school, if they don't have a way of getting on the internet at home, it doesn't help. Now, there are answers out there like the library and that kind of a thing, but the library is not always open, or the student might be doing homework late at night. So there are districts that are doing some creative things.
This community is a very high-tech community and has embraced the idea of being a technology leader in the school district. I hear people talking about our schools and our technology focus, you know, in the community and the pride factor. We've also recently begun an initiative. We're a little over a year into a community-wide Wi-Fi project to allow our community to have lots and lots of free public Wi-Fi to benefit students, but also to benefit, you know, anybody in the community who needs Wi-Fi. We've started in neighborhoods of poverty first on purpose, and we're moving across the city installing as much free public Wi-Fi as possible. And it's a cooperative team effort between the school district and the city of Council Bluffs and lots of other organizations who've helped. So it's really a community that's embraced the idea of being a tech leader, because the people here are proud of what we've done in schools and in the city and in the community in general.
In addition to kind of this high-speed connectivity, we also want to make sure that we have all of the devices in place and that we can sustain them, because there's a lot of devices that are coming into the schools. It's not just what the schools are buying or purchasing, it's also students are bringing in their own devices. Teachers have their own devices. So you wanna make sure that the infrastructure physically can just support that. Another piece of it is just kind of creative long-term budgeting and making sure that you can afford to sustain the vision that you have. A large piece is digital citizenship, making sure that students understand digital etiquette, making sure that devices that are used in the schools are safe and secure, and students understand what that is, that you're in line with federal laws. So infrastructure stretches out to mean a lot of different pieces coming together to make these devices successful in the classrooms.
We're a one-to-one school district, so all kids here in our district, K-12, are issued a one-to-one device. iPads at the K-5, 6th through 12th grade have the MacBook Airs. That provides a piece of equity that all students are on a level playing field.
I think one of the big things that we did this year is we did a technology refresh, so we all got new devices. It had been 3 years since the other devices were in place, and it was time to upgrade. I think that is a big piece, and making sure that we're planning financially for that to occur. And then, you know, the training piece for teachers, because even though the device is the same device, there are more capabilities with the newer versions, and making sure that the teachers are aware of those, and always giving them time to explore. It's hard. Technology is expensive, and making sure that we had the funds in place to support that was one of the key pieces that we had to have in place before we proceeded. Every school district struggles with, how do I fund it, and where's that money going to come from, and what else do I have to cut to make this happen? I think one of the main things that we've done here at Howard Wynn is we are not big on textbook adoption. We do not go out and purchase a lot of curriculum. There's so much stuff on the internet that's free, or at very little charge, that the teachers have really gone out and pursued those things that meet Iowa Core and that they can adapt to use as teaching resources in their classroom. So that's a lot of funds that we have saved just by utilizing the devices that we have.
You know, we got an appropriate use policy that we need to communicate, have people check off on, hold them accountable to that. That's a piece of it. We have very few things blocked here at the school. We try to take those approaches on an individual basis with different students that way. Oftentimes I wonder, you know, should we put the clamps on things a little more? But the reality is, when they leave here for college or career, that things are wide open. And some kids need a little more coaching in that than others, but that's what we're here for too, is to teach those soft skills to help them be employable and be productive after they leave here. It really is a system, and there's a lot of moving pieces to it. And there's a lot of things that need to be going right to make it all work.